Welcome to Spine Educational Channel. This is the second video where we will talk about skins in spine. In previous one, we have covered basics. Now, we will continue by looking into use cases. How to separate them, how to merge them, how to duplicate them, and what to do when we receive a new skin. If you are new with skins, I recommend you to check the first video. I'm leaving the link on the screen. You are looking at Mix and Match project, which you can find here. When you open it first, you may be lost in all of the skins, trying to make sense what belongs where. But in reality, it just consists from 4 major skins. One for boy and 3 variations for girl. Rest of the skins are just parts of the main skins, to allow dynamic customization in the game. In other words, artists just took main skins and broke them into smaller skins. You can do that by moving parts of one skin into a new skin. Let's do that now. Activate the skin you want to take parts from. Drag those parts out from their placeholders. That will remove them from their skin and put them in general domain, where they do not belong to any skin. You'll see them even when you deactivate all skins. Great! Now create new skin, as we did in previous video. Name it. Make sure it's the active one. Drag those attachments into their placeholders. Now they belong to new skin. If you want to copy an attachment from one skin to another, select the attachment you want to copy into new skin and duplicate it. This way we will keep the mesh and its weights. Note that I didn't duplicate the skin placeholder, but the attachment itself. When we do that, new attachment will be put in general domain. After that, just activate the skin where you want to move it and drag the attachment into its placeholder. What we know already is that an attachment should always be inside skin placeholder to work with skins. Before creating placeholder for attachment, check if there is already created placeholder that should contain it. Simply put, if we once created skin placeholder for an attachment, let's say a hat, all heads of the red skins should go inside that placeholder. Try using as less slots and placeholders as you can. It won't affect performance, but will definitely keep the project clean. To exercise what we have said above, I'm going to merge 2 skins into one. Activate first skin, select all its attachments, and duplicate them. New attachments will be deactivated, so we will continue looking at old skin attachments. Let's select and delete them. Don't worry, we have all those attachments duplicated in general domain. They are just not visible in the viewport. I will activate the second skin and move those attachments back into their placeholders. Easy, right? This works if 2 skins do not have common skin placeholders. Let's consider we have 2 skins. One contains shorts, the other one just legs. And we want to merge them. Both skins use same skin placeholders. We will again activate first skin. Let's select its attachments and duplicate them. Let's remove old ones and switch to the second skin. In previous example, we had those placeholders empty, so we just dragged attachments on them. Now, if I do it, shorts will replace the legs. But we want both in the same skin. We need additional slots for each attachment that is common for both skins, to place one over the other. Let's do that now. Select leg slots and duplicate them. Little messy, but wait, I will clean it up. In duplicated slots, I will remove leg attachments, while in old slots, I will remove short attachments. Now, drag short attachments on their placeholders and delete short skin. Great! We have also covered this case. Sorry that we move slowly, I just want to make sure we cover a lot. It's time to go deep into duplicating skins. Assuming you have all rigged with several skins and you receive a new skin, what to do? Should you add it in PSD and re-export or directly add it into the project? And in general, what are those options when we hit duplicate skin? Let's start from the pop-up window that opens when we duplicate a skin. If skin contains any mesh attachment, we will see two more options, apart from rename attachments: linked mesh and inherit deform. Check Spine user guide for more info about linked mesh. But to cover it shortly, you can create multiple linked meshes that will share their mesh structure with the source mesh, such as vertices, edges, texture coordinates, and weights. Any change made to these properties will also affect all its linked meshes. Inherit deform comes with the linked mesh option. Whatever you mark there will be applied to all linked meshes in their properties. And check it to allow keying linked meshes separately from the source mesh. Otherwise, deform mesh timeline will be also shared. And if you have keyed any mesh attachment in that skin in animation mode, you will also see duplicate keys option, which is only available if we separate deform key timelines by unchecking inherit deform. And as it says, if you check duplicate keys option, all deform timelines will be also duplicated for the new skin. And finally, if you mark rename attachment, new attachments will be named using skin and skin placeholder names. If you want that to happen, make sure you've created folder and named attachments correspondingly. Otherwise, images won't be able to load since attachment paths will be cleared and attachment names will work as paths. Now back to the implementation of the skin that just arrived. We will cover two ways. Maybe there are more or some are incorrect. Please let me know in the comments so I can fix the video. First, assume we have new boy skin. It will be without backpack, with red pants, thinner body, and some changes on the head image. New skin seems simple change that uses mostly the same art. Let's duplicate the skin and modify it. Delete the backpack attachment, not the placeholder or slot, but the attachment that's inside. Change pads attachment's color, resize the body, and lastly forehead, we need new art. Let's go and create new folder, call it boy 2, and copy the head from original skin folder. Now let's paint it. If we draw inside the same shape, we can use the same mesh and weights from original attachment. If the shape is different, just mesh it again. Head is ready. To add it into new skin, rename the head part by replacing boy 1 with boy 2. By the way, do you remember rename attachments option when we duplicate a skin? Let me remove boy 2 skin and duplicate again with that option checked. Since we already have a new folder named the same way as our new skin, Spine will look for the same images inside boy 2 folder. At the moment we have only head, that is why we will see only that image being loaded. Okay, this was the first one. With second way, we need to prepare new skin in PSD, which I already did. I apologize to the artist for distorting the characters. I just want to cover as more cases as possible. Rename the folder by adding skin tag. If you leave name section of the tag empty, group name will be used. Export using Photoshop to Spine script. Now, drag generated JSON file onto Spine window and import using existing skeleton with ignore option marked. Nice! We have new skin added. Let's activate it. If you name all parts properly, new skin parts will be placed into existing slots, which are already rigged to the existing bones. However, for new skin, you might need to mesh and weight attachments again. Let's continue. The skin doesn't have backpack, so we don't need backpack bone. If we select that bone, we can add it under the skin. Okay, what happened here? The bone was added under selected skin, but it also was added under two other skins. Why? Because when adding a bone to skin, Spine checks if that bone has attachment under any skin. If it has, Spine will also add that bone under that skin. So what happens is we add a bone into active skin, which is girl 2, and in all other skins that have backpack attachment inside that bone. To confirm what I said, if I revert the bone back and activate any skin that already has backpack, then add the bone to a skin, you will see that the bone won't be added into Girl 2 skin, because Girl 2 doesn't contain backpack attachment. Previously, the bone was added into Girl 2 skin because that skin was the active one. An attachment should not necessarily be inside that bone for Spine to add the bone to skin. If Spine finds any attachment that is weighted or inside that bone, the bone will be added to corresponding skin. Want to know how we'll be dealing with the head that is higher than normal? Check out the next video. Thanks for watching and special thanks to channel supporters. Happy to tell that we have new supporter, Aline Costa. Welcome. Bye guys.